them!
Run! Ruku!
Who am I to argue with financial success? I'm a critic, folks, and sometimes that's what we critics do. 2.5 years ago, Walt Disney and the Walden Media Company teamed up to adapt the first of the C.S. Lewis books in the Chronicles of Narnia series. That was The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe, and it was a huge international success. And now, the same director, Andrew Adamson, has brought Project 2 to the screen, Prince Caspian. In this adventure, the four Pevensey children, their lives already turned upside down by World War II, return to the magical land of Narnia. But magic times come and gone, and the talking animals and enchanted woods have all been laid low by the evil King Miraz and his followers, all of whom apparently come from the land of Swarthia. Meantime, it's been 1,000 years since Aslan, the Christ-like lion, has apparently forsaken his believers. So it's up to the plucky Brits to help good Prince Caspian, played by Ben Barnes, take the throne that is rightfully his.
Prince Caspian?
And who are you?
Peter!
Hi, King Peter.
I believe you called.
Peter Dinklage and Warwick Davis play Trumpkin and Nicabrick, the dwarves allied to the cause. There's minotaurs, trees coming to life, rivers coming to life. Everything comes to life in this movie, except the movie. The director delivers the story just like he did in the first one, and God knows it's faithful to the source. But like that first film, which would have been pretty tough to sit through if it hadn't been for Tilda Swinton as the White Witch, Prince Caspian piles on the action and loses almost all of the charm. The final battle scene, just 2-3 pages long in the book, felt to me longer than a double bill of The Longest Day and A Bridge Too Far. These films aren't crummy, mind you, they're just functional and cinematically uninspired. But you know how the Harry Potter films improved dramatically after they got those first two out of the way? Here's hoping the same thing happens with the Chronicles of Narnia franchise. 2 stars for Prince Caspian. For the Chicago Tribune, I'm Michael Phillips.